Hey everyone, welcome to my online workshop. My name is Dane Ehlert, and I can't wait to share as much as I possibly can to provide tools that you can take directly to your classroom. Feel free to go at your own pace, but I do recommend that you watch the videos and complete the assignments in order as you go. Each section of the workshop builds on previous content, so some things may not make sense in later sections if previous work is skipped. Well, let's jump right in. If I was presenting to you in person right now, I'd have an estimation challenge on the screen as soon as you walked in the room. So let's go ahead and mimic that experience. Take your best guess. How many cubes are in the pile? Go ahead and pause the video in order to give yourself a few moments to think about your response. And spoiler alert, the answer will be displayed in 7 seconds. $201. We bought these cubes at the store for our daughters, and I'm not really sure why they decided $201 was the perfect amount, but I'll trust their judgment. Well, what is this workshop all about? Let's start with a little bit of my story. To be honest, for most of my career, I literally started counting down the days in September. I really struggled with teaching and classroom management for many years, and I kind of dreaded going to work many times. This wasn't what I had signed up for when I got into teaching. I think I was like most teachers, and I imagined teaching would be pretty awesome. I'd show up every day with a smile on my face, and since I would be nice to students and show up for the right reasons, they'd all be so happy and successful in my class. However, this is what teaching actually was like for me. I felt like I was fending off an angry mob of teenagers on a daily basis. Or if they weren't angry, they certainly didn't seem that interested in what I was teaching. But there's good news. Teaching didn't stay that way for me, and by the time my classroom days were over, I was literally in tears because I wasn't ready to leave. I felt like I finally had the classroom that I'd always dreamed of, and I can honestly tell you that it was very similar to the one that my naive first-year teacher self thought I was getting into. So how did it happen? What caused the turnaround? That's what this workshop is all about. I believe there were key changes that made a huge difference, and I truly believe they're changes anyone can make. I promise you that if I can experience this transformation, you can too. One of the most important foundational changes I made was finding ways to unlock curiosity in my students. We have to get students curious if we want the classroom we all hope for. Why is curiosity so important? Well, I think about my two daughters. At the time of this recording, they are nearly 5 and 7 years old. One of the many blessings of children is the fact that they are so curious. They're endlessly curious, and it's refreshing to witness. They want to know the why behind everything. They want to know why things work and what things mean. They're just sponges for learning. However, at some point in life, we all start to lose that childlike curiosity. In fact, by the time many teachers receive their students, especially in later grades, we start to see students who are disinterested. But it doesn't have to be that way. Therefore, one of the biggest goals every day in my classroom is to try to bring students' curiosity back. How can I get students interested and curious again? If I can do that, then they will be ripe for learning, very similar to my young daughters. Let's begin with what provided the foundation for this curiosity unlocking pursuit. Three-act math. This was the first big moment in my teaching career. During my very first year of teaching, a friend from church recommended that I check out a math blog written by someone named Dan Meyer. I took him up on the recommendation, and my view of teaching would never be the same again. Dan Meyer is the inventor of three-act math, and I can't recommend his blog and resources enough. Pretty much my whole career has been inspired by him, and I think you'll be inspired too when you check out his site. How did Dan come up with three-act math? He began with three acts of a movie. In any great movie, there are usually three basic components. Act 1 will almost always have some kind of conflict to get the audience interested. Think about the last movie you saw. I'm willing to bet some kind of conflict was introduced within the first 15 minutes of it, and that isn't an accident. Next, in Act 2 of a movie, the main characters begin to look for resources or create tools to overcome the conflict. They go on a journey or quest to solve whatever problem was introduced in Act 1. And finally, in Act 3, the conflict is usually resolved, and if the movie is really good, there may even be a setup for a sequel. That's the three acts of a movie, and Dan decided to apply the same concepts to math lessons. For act one of a math lesson, we also want to present a conflict for our audience, but this time it will be in the form of a perplexing question. We're hooking the students in by posing a question that they want to resolve. For act two, students are going to go on the journey to resolve the conflict by gathering needed information. The perplexing question triggers them to think about and find the information they need to solve the problem. And finally, in Act 3, we resolve the conflict by revealing the answer to the math problem. That's a high-level view of three-act math, but we still don't really know what it looks like yet. What does a sample three-act lesson look like? How do we implement it in our classroom? Those are questions we'll answer soon, but first you need to experience one as a student, and that'll be our next video.